time I turn around, I see your face.
Lucky, I guess.
Yeah, but it's a matter of opinion. Why the hell can't you just leave me alone? Yeah, it's mine. Now, why don't you just back off, because I'm not in the mood for 20 questions, okay?
I wasn't going to drill you. I'm here to clean up.
Yeah, all I see is us, the maid service, right?
Don't worry, I'm not expecting a tip from you.
Oh, I've got a tip for you. I'm not sure you want to hear it.
What is this? A few days ago, we were really close, and we were good friends, and now you're treating me like I'm some kind of disease. I don't need this.
Prescott.
What?
I had to move out of my apartment last night. That's why I'm crashing here.
Why did you have to move out?
My roommate, I don't know, he kept looking at me like he expected me to pull a knife on him or something.
What? Why?
Oh, gee, Prescott, the name Bowman doesn't mean anything to you.
Oh. Casey, where are you going to live?
Good question.
Attention, everybody. Oh. I'd like to introduce you to the new director of Corinth Community Center.
You're gonna be the director?
I sure am. So, any questions or problems? The buck stops here.
Being the director.
I can congratulate her. You are gonna be wonderful.
Well, I'm gonna try. But enough silly telling around here now. Come on, let's get to work, huh?
Okay.
Well, hey, I'm gonna get out of your hair.
What is this stuff?
Enough. It's just stuff.
Grandma, you can move down.
Gee, that's good. Where are you going to move?
I don't know yet. That's I'm going to head out right now and start looking.
How are you at plumbing?
Plumbing?
Yeah, I was thinking about hiring a handyman for around here. You know, somebody could just be on the premises, check things out all the time. Think you could handle that?
Well, sure, but I don't...
Well, I mean, I wouldn't be able to pay much, but I'd give you room and board and... Well, what do you think?
Yeah. Sure, why not?
Good!
We'll watch where you're going!
I said it first.
Next time, knock, will you?
Were you impressing your security guard, Lou?
I was working out.
Working out? Have you heard of push-ups?
Next time, make some noise.
Oh, God.
I said next time.
The plan, the pot's broken.
Oh, I'm sorry. Look, I really am.
What happened to us? Why are we treating each other like this?
Well, I said I was sorry.
Okay? Well, you couldn't. He's down here helping me. You are the handyman around here instead of dancing around trying to jab your foot into someone's throat. Forget it. I'll do it myself.
Well, make up your mind.
Why are you wearing that costume? You look like some ninja.
For your information, it's a thief.
What are you doing?
It's called Taekwondo.
The martial arts? When did you take this up?
A while ago.
Well, couldn't you pick yoga or something less violent? Sorry, I didn't mean...
Didn't mean what? Violence runs in my family?
No.
Look, I will pay for your damn plan, okay?
Don't bother.
Well, what was that ugly thing for, anyway?
It was for you. It was a housewarming gift for your new room.
Well, you really didn't have to do that.
I know I didn't have to. I was just trying to be your friend, thank you.
I thought our friendship was over. Isn't that what you said?
Well, what I say and what I mean are two different things. Don't you know me by now?
Well, obviously, I don't know anyone anymore. I thought I knew my father.
You did know your father.
Look, I just want to get it out of my life, okay? I want to forget everything that happened. I just want to get it out of my life.
So does that mean pushing me out in the process? Casey, look, I know what you're going through must be hard.
I don't need pity, Prescott. Pity just keeps it on going. I just... I want everyone to treat me normally, like none of this ever happened, okay?
They will, eventually, but it's gonna take some time.
Great. Well, when everyone's had enough time, drop me a line.
Casey, I just want to help you.
I don't need help. You in English.
Fine. And when you decide to rejoin the human race, drop me a line.
Doctor, said it was okay if I came in here for a few minutes. Is it? Casey. It was my father who did this to you. He shot you. And remember, then you fell off the bell tower. He kidnapped your wife, I mean, your ex-wife, and, you and I, we went to stop him, and I told you not to call the police because I was afraid if the police showed up that they might hurt my father. I didn't know he would do this to you. I didn't know. Yeah. Please forgive me. Please forgive me for what I've done to you. Okay.